Good evening and welcome to the College of Complexes. My name is Tim. I'd like to welcome everybody to the college tonight. The college it meets weekly on at the Dapper's East Restaurant. And for our web audience, it's on Addison Street in Chicago. The college consists of the following formats. We first have a brief announcements period. Then we have our speaker. Then we have a question and answer period. After our question and answer period, we then have our infamous rebuttal period, where everybody gets a chance to speak their piece for maybe 5 minutes. My name is Tim. I'll probably be the moderator tonight. And tonight we're having the joys of jigsaw puzzling with Steve Kungis. College regular Steve Kungis will share his observations of doing jigsaw puzzles. This presentation discussion is designed for folks who have never done or completed a jigsaw puzzle, as well as beginners, intermediaries, and expert folks. Bring and give away your old or new jigsaw puzzles.
I don't have any.
This will be a time for giving and sharing. Let's welcome to the stage
pulpit
illustrious college regular Steve Kungis.
I like the pulpit better.
I like the pulpit better.
All right, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the good, bad, and ugly of jigsaw puzzling. We have a fun topic tonight. Before we get started, though, I found this nice poem or saying about jigsaw puzzles. I'm going to hand it out
so
first.
We're going to get started while Tim's doing the technical. So do we have any folks in here that have never done a jigsaw puzzle? Anybody that's never done a jigsaw puzzle? You've never done one, right?
Have you ever done one?
Never done one?
Never?
Never done one?
Jeez.
All right, everybody else has done one, huh? Tim, how about you? You've done one before?
No, not puzzle in Russia, no.
How about has anybody started a jigsaw puzzle but never completed one? There you go. Okay. Okay, a couple of you. All right, is there anybody that's done completed one or more jigsaw puzzles in their life? There we go, okay. So can I ask you guys approximately how many guys have done? Gene, how many?
One or two,
sir?
One or two,
Charlie?
Quite a few, actually.
Quite a few? Okay.
I got three at home right now, ready to go. In the box.
I got one. I'm in the middle of one.
Did
anyone bring jigsaw puzzles to share with others? And the answer is yes. Charlie brought a bunch of these puzzles right here. So throughout the presentation, we're going to ask y'all to come on up and get some puzzles, okay? Pick some puzzles, take them home with you.
Oh.
You, a friend, share,
Steve.
Okay? Spouse.
Damn it.
So what I'd like to do now is to share my thoughts and experiences about what I think about jigsaw puzzling. And I'd also like to get your input. So it's going to be kind of a give and take, okay? So I'm going to ask some questions, I'm going to share some things, ask some questions, all right? So here's the best part about jigsaw puzzles, y'all. So for those of y'all that have not done them or not completed them, first of all, the beauty of jigsaw puzzles are there's no rules. Nobody's putting any rules on you whatsoever about jigsaw puzzles. There's no timing. You could take 5 years, 10 years, 2 months, 2 days, whatever you want to do. It's at your own pace, your own organization style. If you have a 500-piece puzzle and you want to lay out your pieces here, entirely up to you. It doesn't matter. It's your own style, however you want to do it.
If you're not going to use it, make it a little louder.
A little louder?
Just a little louder.
All right. And I usually talk too loud. That's the reason I'm kind of, okay.
No, just louder.
And no one's watching you. No one is watching you do a puzzle unless you like voyeurism, okay? If you like voyeurism, it's a different story. But no one's watching you do jigsaw puzzles. Strip jigsaw, there you go. That's even better. That's all inclusive. Some common characteristics of jigsawers, what I noticed, are decision-making flexibility. So if you're in an area, let's just say the area is, you're working on the orange. You are determined to work on the orange, right? and you're saying, I'm going to do it, but you're not getting anywhere with the orange. So you have to have flexibility. So maybe you go to the white bridge or the blue water or the blue skies. So decision-making flexibility is very important. You need to be patient. It's going to happen. This puzzle will come together if you're patient. And if you're calm, you got to remain calm. You got to be a risk taker. So when you find a certain piece, you got to be able to risk seeing if it fits somewhere or in a certain area. You got to be a risk taker. You got to have attention to details. So you see this, I like to use the example of a mouse in a cupboard. So when you look at this picture, you might see maybe a squirrel on the bridge. So you keep that in mind that there's a squirrel on the bridge. So when you come across that piece, you know where that squirrel goes, or a dog, or a cat. They have all kinds of little neat things in these puzzles. A lot of clues. You got a meditative. Jigsaw puzzling could be meditative. If you relax, just go with the flow, you become one between you and the puzzle, and you're just going with it. You can be logical or illogical, it doesn't matter. It's your puzzle. You do what you want, how you want, when you want. You have to have determination. Perseverance. You gotta say, I'm gonna do this puzzle one way or another. And towards the end, I'm gonna share with y'all a puzzle that I'm doing right now. I kind of dread doing it. It's an extremely difficult for me. It's a difficult puzzle, and I'll share why towards the end. You gotta be organized. Memory. Remember I was talking about the little mouse in a cupboard, or a squirrel, or a raccoon, or a dog, or a cat. You have to have that memory of a certain funky size piece. A unique a sized piece. Keep it in mind for when you come across that as you're going through the puzzle. The ability to laugh. You gotta laugh. When I've been searching and searching for a piece, it might be a day or 2 days or 2 weeks later, I finally found that piece. I gotta tell you what, I burst out laughing because it's so difficult to find that piece.
Right.
My release is laughter. I finally found it, you know? So most of these characteristics you already have. And if you don't have them, you will slowly but surely develop them through jigsaw puzzling. And these are just a few experiences, but you'll also learn how to deal with a big project. Think about it, 500 pieces, that's a big project, 500 pieces. It's a major undertaking, could be. You gotta deal with frustration.
What?
How to deal with frustration, keep you calm, keep you cool. Disappointment. You're going to come across a lot of pieces that you'll be trying. You can't get disappointed. Doubt.
It's very good therapy. Right?
Good therapy. Insecurities, tension. You're to learn how to deal with them. See? Yeah, you know, there's a lot of tension in there if you allow it to get to you. So, okay, now I want to ask the crowd. Well, first of all, I want to share about tools for a jigsaw puzzler. So, anytime before I start a puzzle, I have to have these certain tools, okay? Think about these tools, and I'm going to ask y'all, each one of you, what your tools are. First of all, you have to have a table big enough or wide enough for the proper size puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
The difference is, this puzzle is 18 by 14, okay, which means maybe half this table, this puzzle will fit on half this table, okay? But if you have the 18 by 24, a bigger puzzle, I'm going to need the whole table. So your table is very important to know the size, okay?
I have a question. Tim, I don't want to be on the camera.
Go ahead.
I have a question. Can I ask you?
Go ahead.
So, but it's maybe sometimes not necessarily to throw all the pieces to the table. It's possible to keep in the box and pick up from the box.
That's a great thing.
It's saving, saving
that's,
space.
That's perfect. I'm going to get to the next thing is the bins or pans to put similarly colored pieces inside. So what I do is I used to have three bins, like Ileana says. I just turn the puzzle boxes over and put all the greens in here, all the yellows inside here, all the blues inside there, and then work with the border, and then extra funky looking pieces over here. So the table is very important. Bins, you have to have bins. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to do anything, but here's what I do, here's my tools. Good lighting, I gotta tell you what, the older I get, the tougher it is to see these little details inside there. See that mouse, that squirrel?
Uh-huh.
Measuring tape, you wanna know when you're gonna get to that 18 when you're doing the border, you want to know when you're how close are you getting to that 18 inches. You want to make sure that you're not having extra pieces in there. You want to make sure you don't have less pieces in the border. Good or strong glasses or magnifying glass. So as the older I get, the more I gotta have these strong glasses or a magnifying glass to see the details of these pieces. Very important. A flashlight. Does anybody know why they use a flashlight?
Find them out of war.
Okay, so power goes out?
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Right here, on this puzzle, if you take the flashlight, I mean, if you have these pieces on the table, there's this one piece right here, it's purple. Now, the purple doesn't always come out when the pieces are laying on the table. But if you shine the flashlight at a certain angle, the purples will come out. And plus, the flashlight helps you look a little deeper for the details inside the piece. So, does anybody want to volunteer what tools you guys use? Oh, and a chair. Huh? Go ahead, Tim.
I use none.
You use no tools?
Because I find that jigsaw puzzling, I don't need any more hassle in my life than what you're describing already.
Okay.
I have enough puzzles already in trying to get the places on time, trying to get speeches made with my Toastmasters Club, trying to get a computer running, and Windows 10 certainly is a puzzlement in and of itself, trying to keep ahead of Microsoft and trying to keep things running. So as witnessed by the laptop going bonkers now.
I don't need
more hassle with the piece. The tools I use are a good brain, a lot of good reason, and as a friend says, if you're doing anything, always make sure you allot 3 times the amount of time. Always make sure you have a backup available.
Whoa.
And especially when you're trying to fix your own car, the best way to do it is to just have a parts car available, have a mechanic on call, and make sure you know how to communicate to get help if you need it.
Or take the CTA. Okay.
Not when you live in Algonquin.
Okay. Is anybody else? Go ahead. Charlie, what do you have? What's your tools?
Something to drink.
I purchased a piece, it's a fabric, a green felt.
Green felt.
And it's like you cover your table. And it also has the feature that you can roll it up. And it retains the
portion of the
puzzle that you've
completed.
Oh, it sticks to it.
Yeah.
It's just, yeah.
I have one of those.
Really?
It's wonderful.
Yeah. And you can roll it up.
Yeah.
And come back tomorrow.
And a few things get disturbed, but not many.
Where do you buy that at? Where is it? Where's it?
Wherever they sell puzzles or game
stores
or catalogs.
Puzzles Unlimited, I don't know.
All right, so what other tools do you use? What other tools?
You're correct, the bright light is kind of, they have the lamps now with the filament bulbs, which are kind of useful.
Yeah.
But I don't know your theory there of the purple piece.
Oh, yeah.
Generally, a good lamp overhead centered is the best.
Yeah. If you could do that, if you could make that lamp fit there, yeah. All right, what else? What other tools do you use? Okay, anybody else? Anybody else with our tools? Go ahead.
I probably will use flashlight.
Flashlight? Okay.
Because it's kind of smart and saving time and get more productive.
Okay.
Some of
it. All right. So what else? Anybody have any other tools they use? Gene, like what's the tools you use?
It's been so long, I don't remember.
I got you. Okay.
Sorry.
All right, no problem. All right. Here's a good quiz question. Y'all ready? How old is jigsaw puzzling?
Adam and Eve.
It was around 1760. It was initially used for geography in England by a guy named John Spilsbury. Now, here's an interesting, how about size puzzles? Since you guys, what size puzzles have you attempted to do? Do you remember what size puzzles? Charlie, what size do you always use?
I don't know.
200, 500, 1,000 pieces? What size?
500 to 1,000.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do too. But also there are kind of little puzzles that are just kind of quirky. And then there are puzzles that are like three-dimensional.
Oh, yeah.
Too.
Oh, you like that?
Well, I've done a couple of small ones.
Yeah, I've done one too. Do you like those? You like those?
Yeah, well, is that like a building or?
It's balloons, 3D.
Yeah, but the ones I'm talking about is like a building.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, this protrudes.
It's a 3D.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh, yeah. No,
that's for you.
Keep it.
Okay.
All right. If I may.
Go ahead.
You have one puzzle with roosters. I like roosters.
You like the roosters?
Yeah.
Where is it at? Oh, yeah. So this is a nice one. This is a fun, let me share it about this. This is a puzzle that has a lot of different colors, and it's a bigger puzzle, which takes up the whole table. Well, not really, but you need a table size like this. So you have all different kind of colors. If you get tired of being on the reds, you can go to the oranges, the greens. You got all kind of chickens, hens, roosters, apples, all kind of neat little things to keep you occupied and not get bored of the puzzle. So Liliana said she wants that. There you go. Enjoy.
Thank you so much.
All right.
What about puzzles that are two-sided? One thing on one side and one on the other.
I've never seen that. You haven't?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
I don't have one at home, but I've seen them.
No kidding. I saw a TV.
You have to say, oh, this is red. It goes there. Oh, no. With the other
puzzle. Oh, that is challenging, man.
And then they have some that are just one color and
all
different
things. Yeah.
That's
like my first one I ever got was all green. I couldn't do it. So I'm gonna read the difference between a 500 piece puzzle and a 1,000 piece puzzle. Although it may seem odd, it will take you four times as long to do a 1,000-piece jigsaw puzzle as it will to do a 500-piece puzzle. This is because each time you double the number of pieces, you quadruple the difficulty. So before you start a 4,000 jigsaw piece puzzle, bear in mind it will take you 64 times longer to complete it than it takes you to complete a 500-piece puzzle.
Wow.
It's an exponential curve.
That's an interesting concept. So a 1,000-piece puzzle takes you four times longer to do. You know, this is...
I go to the main library downtown.
Yeah.
They have a lot of them
stuck
on the table.
Yes.
They're there for weeks, I think.
Yes. I try to do got involved in a 5,000-piece puzzle. Oy. It's fun. Very interesting. He's talking about the Harold Washington Library. If y'all don't want to do or buy a puzzle on your own, you just go down to Harold Washington Library, and they have about, I don't know, 3, 4, 5, 6 different tables with jigsaw puzzles going on at all times. They have a 5,000-piecer, a 1,000-piecer, 2,000-piecer. So you just go down and just start doing it, you know? Just it's all for free. It's a good experiment. So has anybody ever glued their puzzles and kept them and put them on a wall or in storage?
Yeah.
You've done that.
I have this puzzle glue and you just put it all over and then you have it.
So it's a glue and then, but you got, how do you, where do you glue? You glue on the top where the picture is or the bottom?
On the top. You spread it over. It's like a varnish or something.
Oh. All right, so also I'm going to share about the five areas of starting and completing a jigsaw puzzle. So here's what I've noticed. First of all, there's the pre-puzzle to the borders, okay? Second area is what's next. After you complete the border, you say, what's next? Number three is the halfway point. Number four is the last 30 to 40%, and five is the last 100 pieces or so. So pre-puzzle to borders.
No.
I'll save that for later. I'm gonna save that when I go over the pictures. I'm going to go over the pictures right now. We got the pictures ready, yeah?
We'll get them.
All right.
Just give me a minute.
Just stay right there and talk.
So the first picture is of my mom sitting at a table with her and me. It's just her. But her and me on Christmas Day or Christmas Eve, she came over. It was my very first puzzle. Well, the very first one I did. It was a 1,000-piecer. I poured a handful of puzzle pieces out. I said, I'm not going to do a 1,000-piece. And then about 3 weeks later, I got a 500-piece puzzle. And my mom just happened to be coming over at that same time. And I said, Mom, can you help me with a 500-piece puzzle? She says, Son, I don't know. The only thing I know is you got to start with the border. So that's how I started my jigsaw, you know, interest in jigsawing. Is she helped me out with the border. And you'll see that picture right here.
As soon as I get it up.
When you were what?
That's a good point. That was a puzzle, not a
Okay, there we go. There we go.
Go here and let him get late.
Gotcha. All right.
Stay behind here.
Yeah.
Wow.
All right. So this is a picture of my mom, and this is with no bins. I didn't know about bins back then and how to organize. We just looked for all the border pieces. That's all we did that day.
Wow.
That evening, all border pieces. And as you see, it was almost too large for the size table. It actually, maybe about a quarter inch was hanging off on each side. So I didn't know about table size, you know. So anyway, here's my mom, and we're gonna go to the next puzzle.
Right. Don't forget to write that. Okay, go ahead. Click.
Yeah.
Try the other. Remember, the mouse is reversed. If you're you. There you go.
All right. So here's the puzzle. As my mom left, she went home. I started working on this puzzle, and I'm gonna tell y'all what.
Wow.
This could have been the beginning and the ending, because wow, it took me about a good month and a half just to get this far. I mean, these pumpkins were like impossible. Not only the pumpkins, but look at the water pump on the right hand side. The water pump was just bear. I couldn't figure it out. This is my first puzzle.
Wow.
And then the house, the birdhouse up in the upper left-hand corner. Monkey, I got that. I mean, this was just a bear. I mean, I didn't know what I was doing, man. But I knew I didn't want to quit. I took this picture because you see the funky shape of the piece? This goes back to that memory thing about, well, this is a missing piece. When you come across this, it can only go in one spot. And you see, as the like the club, and I call it a couple of feet down here. When you come across that, you're gonna know when you come across that piece right there. So things like, but I, according to this these pictures, I couldn't find that piece for a while either. So I was a mess.
It's like, you know, it's like a little cartoon picture.
Yeah.
It's very cute.
So December 24th, and here's how far I got, March 11th.
Wow.
Not very far. I was still struggling that thing. And there it is, finally. What's the date? It's like the 21st, 22nd, I finally finished that thing. But anyway, so that was my very first puzzle. Challenging, no bins, no flashlights, no nothing, no lights, no magnifier, no glasses.
So what time of day you did this puzzle, like afternoon or a.m.?
I just did it at all times. Whenever I had a chance whenever I felt motivated, because to do jigsaw puzzles,
exactly, motivated.
You gotta feel motivated, you gotta be ready for that.
Exactly. desire.
That rejection, the, right. The flexibility. You gotta, you know, be sharp on her. I noticed that anytime I spent like 5 minutes or 6 minutes or 10 minutes, it wasn't enough. That's when I was just getting started, just to get, you know, my mind's opening up a little more. But so nowadays I spend about anywhere between, I don't know, two and a half to 5 hours each session that I do it. I mean, it's all right. I'm trying to point out the pumpkins difficult. I don't know why it was difficult, but for me it was. It just took forever. There's a water can. A water can right in the upper right hand corner. Another tough thing. Just difficult to do. This is the second puzzle I did. Seemed to be a lot easier because the pieces I found were bigger. No, they were the same size. We did a bunch of cats on the front porch, and so this is what I learned. There's the glasses. I finally got glasses. Strong enough to help me out for the details. And there we go. That's the goal. That was always the goal. I always keep that picture in front of me. And this was not that easy, but I did this a lot better, a lot faster. And this one took probably about a month, probably about 4 or 5 weeks. So there we go. It's the second one. I didn't know what to do with these puzzles. Ma'am, you mentioned about the glue. I didn't know if I wanted to keep them or. So I actually kept the first three puzzles. They were all together, and I didn't know. I didn't know if I wanted to keep them, put them on a wall, save them for my garage later whenever I get a garage. I didn't know what to do, so I was running out of room. So finally, I just decided to, you know, tear them up, and that's what I do. I tear up the puzzles now. I take pictures of them, put them in my memories. Friends see them. All right, so there's a Ravensburger. We got this puzzle right here.
That's tough.
Yeah, you know about Ravensburger, huh?
Well, I'm just looking at it.
Yeah, watch this. Watch the pieces. Here's what I'm going to show you. Look at these pieces. They all are the same size. All, you know, they're many of the same color. You know, I just couldn't differentiate them. Another tough one, but what a challenge. You're right, Charlie. It was tough. Look at this. How do you sort those out? I figured out a way. There's my three bins right there. Mm-hmm. And to get to that point was tough. All right. And this is the last. I don't know if anybody, when you come down to the last, I don't know, 100 pieces of the puzzle, what I've learned, or what I do, is if it's a difficult puzzle, I actually take all 100 pieces, you know, as the final 100 pieses, and I put them in order of, you know, the things that protrude, you know, the pieces that protrude, I call them legs. So I put all pieces that have four legs in one column, all pieces that have three legs in another column, two legs, one leg, and then the ones that have no legs go in this other column. And all I do over the last 100 pieces, I just plug away. If it needs a four-piecer, I literally go every single four-legger. I mean, I don't know what else to do at the end. These are so tough. You figure the last 100 would be easy, but it's really not that easy. So I just wanted to share about the last 100 pieces. I kind of have a method behind that madness. All right, so there it is. Once again, all similar looking pieces. Very difficult. Yeah, glad to be done with that one. Oh, there it is. After all that hard work. So if anybody goes home and does a puzzle, would you guys break it apart or would anybody do glue? Would anybody do glue?
I like to do glue.
You want to do glue?
Yeah, because it makes sense.
You know? Would you do glue, sir?
What?
No? Yeah.
Depends? Depends on how much I like the paper.
Yeah,
because otherwise how they will hold. I mean, like, sometimes, you know, even tape, you know, like sketch tape.
Yeah.
You know, like, it makes sense because it's too much work. And some of them very lovely, you know.
Too much work. That's the thing. So how about you guys? Would you guys ever glue your puzzle once you completed it? Would you ever think about doing that?
No way.
I mean, I don't do that. I don't want to do that. But I'm just curious if other people do that or want to do that. Would you guys do that or no?
Then how you keep them, you know, later?
She knows. She knows. Well, what's your name, ma'am?
Janet.
Janet knows. Yeah.
Sometimes I have in the past. Yeah, but
okay. So there's the heartbreak right there. All that hard work, and you're tearing it up. But I don't keep them. And Janet, this is the one I gave you, the 3D.
Yes.
Woo! I ain't doing 3Ds anymore, let me tell you that much, Janet. Difficult. That's at the bottom of my list. Extremely difficult. When you have a 3D piece, and Janet can tell you, you look to the left, it's a little different. Look to the right, it's a different picture. So you're constantly trying to, and even when you're looking at it straight, you know, your puzzle has different looks to it also. So the 3D is really, really funky, but a heck of a challenge. Heck of a challenge, Janet, right?
I haven't done that on the 3D. I've just done it for
building. The building, yeah.
There's a catalog I get, it's called Pieces.
What's it called?
Pieces.
Pieces?
Yeah, it comes in the mail and there's all kinds of stuff like that.
Pieces, okay.
I'm always too tempted to, because I don't really have time to do that anymore, but I'm always tempted to send them away.
So Pieces. Pieces is the name of that magazine, right? Pieces.
Catalog.
All right, so just tough pieces. There it is. I don't know how long this is. This is another 3.5 months it took for this thing. Oh my goodness, wow. I was glad to be done with it. But it looks beautiful. Interesting, very, very beautiful when it's done, but man. And now they have puzzles that are 4-in-1. I'm gonna show you real quick. For like, excuse me, the usual puzzle price is about, I'd say, and I'm pretty, not frugal, but I'm frugal, $11-$12 I'll pay for a puzzle, but that's for one puzzle, but if I can find a 4-in-1, it says $18 or $19, so $19 for 4 puzzles, that's a heck of a deal right there. It's like $4 or $5 a puzzle.
Are all the pieces mixed together on the 4 puzzles?
No, each there's 4 bags inside here. 4 bags, and here's the fun part. You don't know, when you look at the bags, you don't know which puzzle it is. Wow. So you really don't have a choice.
Why not just mix them all together and make it more challenging?
That'd be a 2,000 piece puzzle, and what did we learn about 2,000 piece puzzles? That would be 4 times as long, so how long would that take? Probably 10 times as long as a 500 piece. But yeah.
16 times as long.
16, there you go, 16 times. So that's a good challenge, Tim. There you go, this is yours.
No thanks. I start something like that, I got no space on the table. And, yeah.
See, size of the table, you've been listening.
I also know, too, that I have enough of a puzzle trying to figure out my monthly budget.
There you go. The budget is a puzzle. Big mystery where it all went.
Exactly.
Like a magician.
This is a good puzzle.
All right, here's the border. Mickey Mouse. Yeah, I really don't. I just went for the price of the puzzle. Plus a decent puzzle. But I'm not too particular on what it is. There it is. Beautiful. Isn't that beautiful?
So cute.
I mean, it's just gorgeous when it comes together. It really is. Once again, it's at your own pace. No constraints. No nothing. Here's another one. This is a tough one too.
Uh-huh.
Look at that. There we go. Side by side. Oh, here's the tools. There's the tools right there. The bins, flashlight, tape measure, and glasses. And I turn all the lights on in my apartment, so I get all kind of light over there. I really don't have room for a lamp to be over there, but those are the tools I use, and that really helps out quite a bit.
The dollar store has a lot of puzzles, and they're good. They're really interesting.
Yeah. I love the dollar store.
But this is small. You know, those boxes are part of like, I don't know, I can make like for 20 minutes, just like that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I thought you said you never completed a puzzle. Come on. All right, I'm listening to you.
It's very small.
All right, so there's the tools, once again, the two pins. Same thing, Charlie, Ravensburger, oh my goodness. All the same size. There's a tape measure. You just gotta make sure, because sometimes these pieces.
No, just let it go.
Sometimes these pieces.
Don't worry.
That's being a puzzlement tonight.
Exactly.
What that's called is a memory accessing problems. I haven't seen some of these for 5 years. And that means we're gonna have to restart. Again.
So it's rebooting?
Well, hopefully now, once it gets going, we're going to have to reboot. I don't know why we're having so much trouble.
It's a puzzle.
How apropos for tonight, huh?
A puzzle moment. And you know how much a puzzle will drive me up a tree?
How much?
Lots.
Is it in your budget?
I don't want to have to, I don't want more stress. So what you're talking about to me is something that is not acceptable. I have enough trouble dealing with.
You think it was because of something I hit or is it just.
No.
It's going down?
That's why we have a friend called
why
Paul.
Why would a picture puzzle be stressful?
Because not trying to complete it. Oh, come on.
It's the opposite. It's kind of a slow, tedious process.
That's exactly. I don't need more.
That's not pressure.
So I'll tell you what. Hey, while we're killing some time, why don't you guys come on up and pick some puzzles out that you would like to try at home?
We're gonna be up.
There's no time constraints. No. I'm not gonna ask you if you completed it. Just come on up and pick any puzzles you want. Okay.
Okay.
Puzzles, you got music, CDs, come on, get any puzzles you want, guys. They're all kind of neat ones.
It's starting to boot up again and I know it's ready.
Don't be shy. Come on, even you, Tim.
Can I take this?
Yeah, take
it. You're challenging me enough tonight. You're challenging me enough tonight with the moving around and all the other stuff.
Hey, I know, I saw that. You're earning your money.
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
Dressing.
Oh, dressing is ranch. Give me ranch, please.
All
right, Jim. Where are you at, Jim? Come on.
Oh, all right.
Come on, guys. Come on. Come on. Sir? Sir, come on. Come on. Come on up and get one. No? All right. Take a couple. Don't be shy. Take a couple. We got plenty. Plenty to give away. Puzzles, music, poetry. Yeah, don't forget, back here, all kinds.
What the hell is.
We're back at it, yeah?
By memorizing all those downs and pieces first.
Right. What?
I memorize.
same way I do.
Yes.
Perfectly wrong.
Memorize all 1,000 pieces.
You got to do that. You got to do that for the details. Like when I first get the puzzle, mm-hmm. I look at all these little things, man.
Yeah,
exactly. People on the bike, guy standing over here, picket fence, out here the flag, there's two flags, I think there were. Flag here, wording on buildings, you gotta memorize all this stuff, it all matters.
Okay, Steve, you're back up.
It all helps.
You're back up.
It all helps. Thank you. Every little detail. Gene, you get a puzzle?
I'll go come look at it.
Come on, good shot. You did good, Tim. You did good.
That's right, Tim. Very right.
All right.
Why anybody would want more stress, I do not know.
Question.
Different strokes for different folks.
I know.
It depends.
I can do an all-night editing session and have no problem.
I like the puzzle you bought. I like this answer.
Right, a lot of details in this puzzle.
Wow.
That Charlie was just mentioning, he likes to study the puzzle. He was teasing about memorizing every single piece. But that's what you do, you look at the puzzle. I mean, you look at the picture on the box and say, man, there's all kind of details. Like this one right here, you got the flag, a couple of American flags. One right here, another one waving over here. You all kind of people at the bottom on a bike, names on the buildings. So you all kind of details to give you hints. It's not just, you know, take a guess on how to go about this. It's there's some method to the madness. There it is, three bins.
Wow.
There's the tape measure. I wasn't sure about the size. Difficult piece.
The good tools.
There it is. That's the one you have, Ileana. Good luck with that one.
Yeah, nice.
It'll be fun.
Yeah. Oh.
All kind of pieces there.
Wow.
And you got to make sure before you start any puzzle, you got to have a little beer. Oh, yeah, sure is. That's why I spent 5 hours doing the puzzle.
It's clever.
All right, there we go. Same puzzle, thank you, man. Difficult pieces. Difficult shape, the difficult pieces. There we go. Coming in close, it's called the coop. Look at how those pieces are funky. I still couldn't find them. Looking and looking, I couldn't find them. All the roosters, scarecrows, finally coming to the close, finally. They're still not done. Come on. Come on. What are you doing? All right. Finally, the last piece right there. This is Nana's kitchen. Nana's kitchen was kind of tough at first. Working on the chairs, I couldn't figure that out. And then the cabinets. It was just tough. Just a tough one. And this one right here, this is what I'm working on right now. Extremely difficult because they're all, like Charlie was saying about one of the puzzles, where it's all the same color.
Lion the king.
I mean, this is extremely difficult.
It's very difficult.
I've never sat down to do a puzzle. I stand when I do my puzzles, but this one I had to get a chair because down here, a lot of details, a lot of animals, but the pieces, it was extremely difficult to do. And I mentioned about the prepper. With the flashlight, if I shine it on some pieces, if you see the purple right here, it already comes out with the flashlight. So that was good. But right now, I put 10 hours into this puzzle, and here's how far I've gotten. 10 hours. This is for you. This is for you, Tim. 10 hours. Here's what you get.
Steve, I have a question.
No, I'm kidding.
Steve, I have
a question. Really, I'm down to 2 bins nowadays. 2 bins is enough. Look at these pieces. All right, ready? It's coming down to it. 'Thomas Kincaid, I like his puzzles a lot, they're pretty cool. I mean, look at it, it's tough, just tough going in. So here we go, we're getting there. There's the chair. I've never used a chair until you started this puzzle. It's the first time I've used a chair. Look at this. I believe it's as far as I've gotten. Oh no. Let's go a little more. There we go. That's it. And that's 10 hours. I spent 5 hours in one time and 5 hours in a second time. This is it. But I ain't giving up. I ain't giving up. That's what Jigsaw puzzles really are all about. It's not giving up. Persistence, perseverance, just the joy of figuring out these things.
Wish I had a block of time that was 5 hours long.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, that's the other thing. You gotta have some time. I mean, you always have the weekends, you know?
Postmasters events.
Evenings. You have evenings for maybe an hour or two.
Yeah.
Instead of doing laundry, why are you doing laundry? You can always do a Jigsaw puzzle. Right?
No.
30 minutes for the wash while you're doing a puzzle.
Keep the computers editing up and get the video done that I got to keep back up.
45 minutes for the dryer while you're doing a Jigsaw puzzle.
Good episode of Modern Marvels.
Instead of watching TV, turn the TV off and do some puzzle. Put the radio on. Right?
Then curse at Donald Trump as he goes through on NPR.
Steve.
Yes, go ahead.
Did you ever glue or did you ever put tape between? Then how you keep them?
I don't keep them. Janet keeps them. I don't keep them.
Wait a minute. So you spend like 5 hours and then you do?
When I complete it. Anytime I complete a puzzle, I enjoy it for like 2 weeks, you know. Oh. I say, man, that was a son of a gun. Or, you know, I put my fist up at it, say, you were a tough son of a gun.
Uh-huh.
Every time I want to buy it, I just want to, you know, punch the puzzle.
And
seriously, and then I enjoy the beauty of it.
Okay.
And I know all the sweat, blood, and tears that went into it.
Right. And then what you do after?
I tear it up, just like all of these. I did all these.
Really?
Tear it up. Yeah, I don't keep them. I don't have a desire for that.
I have another question very quick. If you really, really, really like it, like one picture or two, can you glue or can you stick
to it? Janet says you get that glue.
No, not glue. I'm talking about like even scotch tape. Did you ever use it?
Not me. No. Janet. Janet's the expert.
No, it's called Puzzle Saver.
Puzzle Saver.
Yeah.
It's like a barbecue.
Not a bad idea. You know, like once in a while.
Yeah.
Scotch tape? That's ridiculous. How
are you going to use scotch tape? The scotch tape, you all actually, gotta, it's very easy.
You got to do a puzzle like that with scotch tape? No, tape, like if you want to keep picture, if you think you will rip again, then...
You're going backwards.
I know.
And it depends, you know?
How are you going to keep a puzzle like that
with scotch tape? It really depends. But this, I wanna
do
this. I don't know how long it takes. It's really.
All right, huh?
You're good for.
All right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna share the first phase of the puzzle. Okay. So this might give you guys some ideas, some hints. And I hope it doesn't confuse you. If it confuses you, let me know at any time. Okay. So when I get the puzzle, I'm gonna get one. Like the one I'm on right now, okay? You just get the puzzle, you get the box, like Charlie was saying, about joking about memorizing it, but you just look at the puzzle. I mean, right here you got Mickey Mouse. So you have his red robe, he's standing on a brown rock, there's some purple or purple-ish flowers down here, there's a coliseum, you know, columns over here, looks like a little water fountain over here. The sky has some kind of a rainbow thing going on. A unique pinkish color over here. So you're looking at the puzzle before you start. Just look at it and see what the heck it's really showing.
Right.
Showing some stairs going up there,
right.
Little creek over here, little mini waterfalls, colorful flowers in
try
the bottom
memorize,
over here.
Right? Try to memorize.
Huh?
Try to memorize.
Right. So that's what you do with the puzzle at first. You just look at it. Try to see what you can find for little small clues or hints or things that I pointed out, okay? So then after that, you get the puzzle out of the bag and you get your bins. You get your bins, two bins, and you get your puzzle pieces. Just put them all in a pile.
Uh-huh.
And the goal is First thing you're going to do is a border, okay? The border is the very first thing. It's your goal. That's your goal you're going for.
What is
it? So as you have all your pieces in eye on, what you're doing is you're turning every single piece over, looking for the border piece. You're turning every single piece over, looking for a border piece, okay? So there it is. I've turned over all the pieces, and on the right-hand side, these are all the border pieces, okay? I don't know what pieces I want to put in what bins because this was a difficult puzzle. It just, everything seemed to blend together. It was the same color. Mm-hmm. So anyway, the main thing is I got all the, on the right-hand side,
what does it mean?
All of the border pieces, okay? So once you get the border pieces, then you get them all together and start putting the border together. And as you're putting the border together, you try and decide what pieces go into what bins. So I kind of get an idea what to put in what bin. Now I figured out two bins, three separate piles of funky pieces. So two bins, they're basically the same kind of color of the two bins. You know, one bin has this color, dark brown. The other one is light color. And then down here, these are a funky color, purplish color. And these are animals. These are animals that are inside these pieces right here. And so what I have is two bins, three special piles, and the borders on the right hand side. Okay. There we go. We're about to begin the, there it is. I want to see what 18 by 14 looks like. Thomas Kincaid, let's start putting this piece together. I need the flashlight, need my glasses. There it is, need to know the size. Coming together. Hey, the border is done. Woo! That was, took a little while from the start to get to the border. All right. All right, I got two last quiz questions, and that'll be it, okay? Who can tell me the largest jigsaw puzzle that has been put together? This was in 2011, the largest jigsaw puzzle ever put together. Where was it? How many pieces?
22,000.
Okay, keep going higher.
24.
A lot higher.
200,000.
Higher.
1,000,000.
Lower.
500,000.
500,000. It was 551,232 pieces put together in Vietnam in 2011 at a university in Vietnam. Has anybody watched movies or not really? You watch movies. There's a franchise called Saw. Has anybody ever seen a Saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? There's a crazy nut inside there, and his name is his nickname is Jigsaw. They call him Jigsaw. I figured that'd be a neat thing. But he was a crazy guy. So I think that's why they call him Jigsaw. Anyway, so that's it. That's it. Thank you.
Take questions now.
Yeah, okay, questions. All right. Thank you. Hey, I'm sorry. Before I take questions, please. We're not taking these puzzles home. You guys got to take some home and bring them to your friends, family, neighbors, Christmas gifts, birthday gifts. Take them home, please, okay?
Wow.
Take them all home. We're not taking anything home with us. All right, go ahead, questions.
First one.
Sir.
What got you started in the puzzles?
Yeah, good question.
Why do you keep doing puzzles?
Gotcha.
And what is the motivating factor that keeps you puzzling?
Gotcha. What got me started in jigsaw puzzles were a couple of things, really. One is, I love Sudoku. Does anybody do Sudoku out here? Sudoku? Janet, all right. So anybody else Sudoku? No?
I did it a little while.
A little while? Well, I've been doing Sudoku for like 3 years, and I thought, zero, 1 through 9, how many times? I still like Sudoku, don't get me wrong. But I thought, after 3 years, I'm looking for a next challenge. And that's when I branched out to get that 1,000-piece puzzle at Target, but it was all green, so that 1,000-piece puzzle scared the heck out of me, and I put it away, and 2 weeks after that, I went to Target again and got a 500-piece puzzle, and then I got the 500-piece puzzle, brought that home, and all of a sudden, my mom was coming over, and she helped me with the border, and that got me started. So, and what keeps me going, this is me personally, what keeps me going at Jigsaws is, it's one hell of a challenge, man. Every single puzzle is different. You gotta organize it the right way. Sometimes I feel meditative. Sometimes I feel frustrated. Sometimes I'm excited. Sometimes I'm amazed that I just relax and you know, spend 5 hours with this puzzle.
And I bet you it passes by like that.
It does. It does, especially when you're drinking a little beer, you know. And it does. It does pass by like that because you're so engulfed, so immersed into this world of sizes and angles and colors, and you're just so in tune with it. That's where you become, like you were saying, you're meditative.
Right.
You become in tune with it.
Relaxed. I'll get that way when I want to. When I watch a movie I don't like,
yeah.
And I've got my editing program up, and I'll change the ending of it.
Really?
I've that's how I learned the editing program, was to change the ending of a movie.
No kidding.
And it took me 3 days to do one of them, but
I love you. Still do it? Still do it? Change anything?
What I find now with me, if I have a block of time like that, I almost have to plan for it. You know, I have to plan like a day off,
sure,
just to do something like that. And then I have an end in mind when I do it.
Gotcha.
You know, the last time I changed the movie was I took a British costume drama with a bunch of women in it and changed the ending to a Clint Eastwood shootout.
See, you entertain yourself just
that,
like
I'm
Jigsaw.
Just saying, that's why I can relate to the Jigsaw puzzling thing. I dare not put that on YouTube because there'd be all kinds of copyright violations.
I hope we got that on tape, though. Yes, Dan, go ahead.
I just wonder, did you ever play chess or checkers?
I did attempt to play chess when I was a young guy, and
what happened?
It's really difficult, man. I enjoy it. I'm very impressed with it, impressed by it.
Yeah.
Ever since I was a kid, they had a lot of chess clubs when I was a kid. Yeah. I was born in '63, so they had, you know, when I was a teenager, they had chess clubs. Nowadays, the only chess club I found was over in Edgewater, and they meet like every other Tuesday, Thursday, whatever it is.
Yeah.
But that's the only one I found around. And I learned that I'm a beginner, and I can only play with beginners, because if I play against somebody who's experienced in chess, it shows on their face, they're bored. And you know, they really don't want to teach beginners. They really don't, man.
Right.
And I know that. I can see it. I can feel it.
Just go down to North Avenue Beach sometime.
Sure. Been there, too. But once again, those guys are all good. Just watch a couple
games.
They're
all good. Man. They're hustlers. But if you stick by the rules, you learn something fast.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead. Next question.
And I like pocket puzzles, word find puzzles.
There you go. Word finds. So is that a crossword puzzle?
Like you have to
you circle the word.
Word find.
Yeah, I like that.
Bucket find. I like that.
That's good. Go forwards or backwards. You can write the word, can be forward, backward, slant.
Right. Farmville on Facebook.
All right, go ahead, Charlie.
Isn't that chess like a war game? Where you defeat your enemy?
Uh-oh, Dan.
And if you're a pacifist,
he's trying to pull you in.
You wouldn't do it.
He's trying to pull you in.
He wouldn't appeal to you because you don't want to defeat somebody. I know one gets defeated, right, by doing a puzzle. Everyone wins because
no
you get a pretty picture at
no
the
blood.
End.
No blood.
You don't defeat anybody. There's no losers. In a picture puzzle.
So seriously, do you play chess, Dan?
I used to play in tournaments, actually.
You did?
But I lost a lot with little kids, and I got tired of it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, same with Edgewater. I'm playing little kids for my first time, and they're like bored with me.
I used to play a lot myself in high school, and I'll get into that part during the rebuttal.
All right. Go ahead, Charlie. What else?
I guess you've been buying your puzzles mostly at the store, because I got started in it because of, I picked ones with particular subject matter. Like railroads of the United States, and it had something on 25 railroads.
That's cool.
I like those with a lot of different content to it, you know.
No more of that.
Instead of these mamby-pamby little picture things, you know. Country lane.
Like Nana's Kitchen.
Yeah. Makes me want to puke.
There are places that'll turn
pictures. Well, you have to go online, I think.
Well, that's what it is. Just, you know, Amazon, this is all 100% Amazon for, you know, like I said, $11 for one, $12 for one, and then the four in one is about $20, so. But these are the only things that they have on there for that price are these pictures right here. So Charlie's right, they don't have neat stuff, you know, cool stuff. This is it. This is what they have online. So you're right, you gotta go to a specialty site. Is there a special website you go to, Charlie? Is there a specific name?
No, I haven't.
All right.
I'm backed up, so I haven't been buying any.
Gotcha.
You always buy more than you see one, and so you pick it up, and pretty soon they start piling up.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's a service out there, you can send them a picture and they'll turn it into a puzzle.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Kind of hit on this, kind of avoid these tricky puzzles, right? Is that your advice? I mean,
Do I avoid tricky puzzles, or do I like tricky puzzles?
Or do you like or avoid, like this 3D stuff?
I'm willing to try them at least once. So then I can say definitely whether I'll do it again or not. And like the 3D, I mean, It was a difficult challenge. Would I ever do it again? I won't say never, but if I can avoid a 3D, I'll avoid a 3D probably for the next 5 years. In 5 years, I'll probably go back to doing one. But yeah, if it's like a Ravensburger, like you were mentioning.
Explain what Ravensburger is.
Yeah, let me show you two Ravensburgers.
Are they like the champagne of puzzles or something like that?
Well,
explain what a Ravensburger puzzle is.
These are the ones, actually, they're the same size. So, like if you have this kind of a puzzle, like Nana's Kitchen, you might have a piece like this size, a piece like this size, this mixed size pieces. But a Ravensburger, they're like, all of our pieces will be 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, all the way around. So there's no funky sizes. And when you get the same color, like if you're looking for a red or orange, all the pieces just blend together and they become extremely difficult, man. Did I explain it okay?
Yeah, I just didn't know what the difference in a brand was.
He likes to keep his sizes all the same. All the pieces are the same. Nothing jumps out. An orange piece is like an orange piece, like another orange piece. But over here, you know, if you have the chair, you're gonna have a bigger piece, a smaller piece. You know, that's really the difference between a Ravensburger and other ones, what I've noticed so far.
Because it seems like they're all cut from a master die of some kind.
They're all different sizes, man. Different sizes, yeah. They're all different cuts. Yeah. Anyway, what else? Anybody else? Questions, comments, concerns? You guys got to take some. Go ahead.
I'm not so sure this idea that bins is such a good idea, because you're taking the pieces off the... Wouldn't it be better to have all your pieces kind of like maybe you don't have table space or something? I just don't think putting them in separate bins is such a good idea. I mean, you want to segregate the colors.
Yeah.
Or design, but to physically put them in a container, I guess it's all right, you know. Doesn't that make it inconvenient?
No, just the opposite. So in other words, if we have the puzzle, and I'm looking for dark pieces, I know all my dark pieces are in that bin in the upper left-hand corner. If I'm looking for a lighter piece, it's all in this bin over here. So what I've done is I've actually cut my possibilities in half if I'm trying to search through those pieces. So it cuts it down in half to answer your question. So it makes it a lot easier and less time consuming. I mean, that's what I found. But you know, once again, your tools are your own.
You know what I mean? They're not flat, it doesn't appear. I don't.
Oh, are there pieces on top of other pieces?
Yeah.
Yes.
That makes it difficult.
Yeah.
You don't want piles.
I mean, it's better to have it. It's better to have it segregated like that than to have them spread out. I mean, like you were saying about the table size, I don't know the table size. And if I go into a bin, I'm just rifling through it.
Then again,
and enjoying it.
Isn't the time you spent doing all that separation, does that really pay off?
Yes. Because if I'm looking for a piece, and let's just say it's a light-colored piece, I'm going to go up to that silver bin, and I'm looking for that light-colored piece only in the silver bin. I'm not stumbling over the dark pieces in the left-hand bin.
I think that's too much time.
Okay, so then don't use bins, yeah. I mean, for me, it works. Go ahead, Ileana.
Right now, it just comes perhaps to my mind how to make a little bit easier. It's a little bit more, you know, like clever, maybe. It's good. But again, try to saving time perhaps. But it's, again, it depends from the player, you know. So what my point is, like you mentioned, first we have to observe, take a look at the pictures. Even with magnified glasses, who interested? I'm not using, thanks for that. So every details, like if you dedicate it to the puzzle, like look at those pieces, and like you mentioned, like what I like it about, like left side and right side, okay? So my point is, like before you do puzzle, maybe better to even to put a small plastic bag. Okay, so maybe darker pieces, and then, okay, you see like this is more between darker and maybe not very darker, like 50-50. Do another like plastic bag, and more, let's say like this, like you said, it's pretty difficult to do this color. So also like, let's say like bright more color to put in another bag.
So a lot more segregation. You would segregate a lot more. Is that what you're saying?
Right.
Sure.
And then
sure. Start
to do puzzle from the scratch. That's my
point. Amen. This is the way you'd like to do it. You should do it that way.
No, it's pretty cool.
I'll tell you what I really.
Good.
Maybe. I don't know. No, I know.
Never try to put an operating system on a computer after you have a beer.
Yeah, this is.
So alcohol and technology do not go together. All right, so who's got remarks, rebuttals? Come on up.
I'm going to go first.
Come on up.
Hi.
Yay. Take some puzzles home. Take them home, really.
Okay, can I take this one?
Take them home, more.
This name?
As much as Steve Kungis is into his puzzles, it brings to my own mind, you know, and I'm kind of being a little bit facetious here by kind of dismissing what he's doing, but in another sense, I'm just as guilty as charged with my own passions and things. when he mentions the word chess, for example, I actually started playing the game when I was in high school, or even earlier. And my first opponent was a master chess player by the name of Ricky Duncan when I was about 7 or 8 years old. We played over 100 games before I finally beat him in checkmate. Then I got good enough to where it was a 50-50 mix. Then I went to high school and I usually did about a 50-50 mix on this stuff. Went to college, and again, I had a big, venerable opponent. Yeah, Dave, you know all about it. Again, 120 games before I beat him. I put it away after college, and I finally wound up going back into the Navy. And when somebody found out that I was a chess player, the guy's name was Cabrera. The same thing happened. It took me 120 games to finally beat him. But what I didn't know was that he was a Philippine chess champion.
Oh, wow.
And we started, after a while, getting into a 50-50 mix of games. Then Ensign Greenwood came on board. And again, a similar thing. Him and Cabrera were going to be 6-hour-long chess matches.
Wow.
He finally got to me, and again, it only took me about 45 games before I beat him. But little did I know that he was the United States national champion.
Wow.
And after I got out of the service, I haven't really played much. But I did find that there's a lot more to life as a young man than just going to the tavern and drinking, which is what I used to do a lot of. And I always found out that I did like to have a hobby or something to associate myself with. This is exactly why I started coming to the college and liking it. Exactly why I got into my Toastmasters group at the year 2000. I found that I've always enjoyed the art of performance and public speaking. I've always been enthralled by technology. And I think the key event to me that really started on my videotaping journey was there was a gal, her name was Jill Morgenthaler, and she gave this really intriguing speech on how she met Saddam Hussein in person. I don't really want to get into the details of it. It's fully disclosed. If you look at my website, you'll find me interviewing Jill at some point. I don't remember where it's at. But I got into it, and I really started learning the fine art of taping. Albeit I don't, you know, I know how to tape an event now, but I will tell you, the next challenge for me, if I ever wanted to go commercial, is to actually learn how to do a wedding.
Uh-huh.
And it's going to take, they say it takes every hour of an event that's long, they say it takes about 10 to 20 to really edit it up right and do something. And of course, there are schools in there that help you do that, including the Illinois Videography Association. I've also found now that you have to kind of, if you let your life be ruled by your passions, the next thing you're going to do is it's going to fill it up so much that you won't have much time for anything else.
That's good.
And even now, my schedule's so full that if I want to really do something else has to give. I would highly recommend all of you, you know, if you're into anything, whether it be sewing or puzzles or anything, there is going to be some kind of group, whether it be online or local, that will have a passion that you have, that will be of like-minded fellows. You know, a lot of people who are professional activists like Charlie and whatever do the political thing. The point is to get out, get involved, network with like-minded people, and learn a few things. You can do a lot. I'm sure now that, you know, with your puzzle and stuff, you can get into a group with Sudoku or some kind of puzzle in the Washington Library or something, because you'll find a lot of like-minded people. And what the nice thing about our country is this, is that you do have associations. You do have places that you can go to. every week I get something or another that another association needs a professional speaker to come in and talk, or that somebody else needs to do something. My basic involvement, and I'm starting to ramble here, so I'll wrap this up. I encourage all of you, whether it be through the college, which I've made a commitment to, but coming every week till, or like me, to the fine art of public speaking, or even the video editing that I do, and maybe having a little bit of recreational things by changing the end of a movie. Yeah, it can be something else. I will say this. In college, I would maybe pull an all-nighter once or twice a semester. Last year, there were almost 21 nights where I didn't get any sleep because I was so engrossed in an editing project. I would start maybe about 9 or 10 o'clock, and the next thing, oh my God, it's 5 in the morning, and I got to go back to work. And I'd pay the piper the next day, but I've now learned if you're going to do that, do it on a Friday night so I can sleep the next Saturday. Or, you know, make sure you plan the time out accordingly to where I have a couple of days off. But even then, that gets difficult because when people find you around. You know, and I think, though, it's much better to spend the time with a group of friends or people than it is sometimes by yourself. But everybody does need their downtime. Let's get our next person up here to rebut.
All right.
And if you want to just talk about your hobbies tonight, please do so. I'd love to hear it.
My hobby.
Your hobbies or what you do for leisure. Gene, how about you?
Most of those are against the wall.
Come on up. And we got an open mic.
Yeah. My hobbies.
Or something, just, we got a good 10 every buck. Go ahead. Charlie, come on.
My hobbies.
Charlie.
Oh. My hobbies.
Yeah, Charlie, yours is...
My hobbies. My hobbies do not include doing sappy puzzles of animals.
Right.
These are irritating. These are not an enjoyable experience.
Your hobby.
Nevertheless, let's thank our speaker for the other pronouncing. It was pretty interesting here. We seem to have some differences of opinion. Nothing. I think his spin system is a waste of time, and conceivably why his calculated period of doing the puzzles are so long. I got started doing them for no other reason than I found one with an interesting subject matter. It was something historical. I think it was battles of the Civil War or something like that. Different portions with a little bit written about it. I did another one of railroads of the United States, just had all sorts of, actually about, if you want to think about it, like 10 or 20 different separate little puzzles. The other thing is, you're doing them by yourself. Now, another way to do puzzles is collectively,
right,
with others. And when you're visiting, it's probably preferable method than watching TV or something, which you shouldn't really do if you're visiting with others, because it's fully, anybody can collectively, 2, 3, or 4 people can gather together around the table and work on the puzzle and converse at the same time if you want. Multitask. It's not that difficult in doing a puzzle. So collectively, and it gives a shared goal or experience to the group on doing it. And I noticed some people, they do this on social media now, they will post the progress they're making on their puzzles, and sometimes over a weekend or something like this, holiday weekend, you can follow them periodically. They'll post the progress like our friend was doing here tonight. So you can see how they're progressing along. I'd avoid gimmicky puzzles, actually like your 3D. Avoid them. The more complicated the picture,
the better. How can I say that? Like he's saying, those pumpkins, especially if you had, you can imagine if you had something that was clouds in the sky with little differentiation, would probably take, I actually, the one puzzle I did give up incorporated a lot of sky. It was a Santa Fe diesel engine. Till finally I gave up on it. It just was not fun. I haven't done that too often. Actually, I kind of missed some of the pieces. I wasn't careful in moving. I was moving. So I said, well, I think I lost some pieces. I'm not going to bother with this, you know. I think I even had gotten it used, so it wasn't. But yeah, if you have something where it's all one color, you're just using only the data that you get from the shapes. Yeah. But you can pick out things you like. If you like sappy things with dogs or whatever, stuff like this. I think also these might be a little small in size. Nevertheless, they will fit on any small space that you can return to it from time to time, you know. They're a leisure time activity. Unlike Tim is claiming, it's some pressure. Now, unlike chess, where you're out to defeat somebody, and if you like things where there are winners and losers, if you think society should be differentiated between winners and losers,
war.
You know, then you play chess. You know, if you are a more accommodating person, as I am, and like to create things, like the creative processes of humanistic activities, then you do picture puzzles instead. You know, picture puzzles of little animal babies, things like this. But anyhow, help yourself here. We've got more door prizes than prizers, so please help yourself. All right. Thank you very much, Sid.
We've got one more. All right, Charlie.
Hey, here comes Tim. Hey,
give me this Chinese thing when you're done. I want this Chinese.
My name's Dan.
We're done with this?
And I don't do puzzles. But I respect somebody who does puzzles because they have a lot of patience and they have a lot of technical ability that I don't have. I write letters to Mad Magazine. The one I showed you today was the number five since 2010. I've been sending letters to Mad. So 2010, 2011, 15, 16, 17.
Wow.
I've had five letters published in Mad Magazine.
Hey.
So, thank you.
Get Alfred E. Newman's autograph.
What?
Alfred E. Newman's autograph?
Yeah.
Right. Cool.
So, yeah, in my spare time, I write.
Alfred E. Newman for vice president.
Yeah. So, actually, I played chess for a while, but my highest rating was about 700, so that's pretty low. And so I have talents in other areas, so this is my number 506 letter. And it goes something like, anyway, thank you.
Come on.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
All right, I'll read it. Since you want to, you know, read it. It's the title of it, Going Through an Awkward Phase. In number 503 and page 27, Jeffrey Lassen says, "Whoa, Nelly." Do people still say "Whoa, Nelly" in 2010? Doesn't this have something to do with stopping horses? Daniel Weinberg, and it's for me. So they say, this is their response, "Cheese and Weinberg." Are you kidding? That phrase has never been bigger. Why, you just used it twice. Thanks for spreading the word, editor. And actually, I did not write that letter. I swear to God. But I sent another letter, and they put my name on the letter that Dan wrote. But So it's very complicated.
What do you want, Alfred E. Newman? Thanks. You know, you're almost editor.
What do you worry?
Now might be a little bit of a good time to just kind of elaborate a little bit on my hobby and some of the stats we've been getting from some of the College of Complexes videos. You know, what's been in our top 10 lists and what's been going on for a while, because YouTube is a really good place for it. What I have on the screen, and I'm going to be moving over to the thing, I want to refer everybody to the projector up here for a little bit. And I want to kind of make it clear what we're kind of doing here with this stuff. We, what I have up here is our top 10, my top 10 videos of all time. I think this is all time, or maybe no.
Who's it?
This is my YouTube account. And the funny thing is, you're still finding what's going on. But our, you know, the electoral migraine, which is something I haven't done, which is our most recent video, was the one that
1,000
over 1,000 views.
Jonathan.
Really?
And I think that's been just in the last 28 days.
Wow.
That's him. The next one that's been really popular. And again, we're just looking at the last 28 days.
Wow.
Is Ted Duranda's thing on the false flag and diabolical attacks of the U.S. government. Something 1,400.
Wow.
Our debate from the 13th of the thing, the thorium debate, when we had John Kutch and I think Dennis Nelson going back at it from 2013, just over the last 28 days, has had quite a bit of a lot of hits. Of course, you'll find that one of the things I could never quite figure out, and this has been consistently, was one from the 13th cold case file investigations. It was one we did a number of years ago. Now I can extend the time out and go for the, let's just go over to the last year, the last 365 days. And what you're gonna find, if we can go back up here, I think we gotta get back up to the other screen here. Hang on, I'm in the middle of trying to get analytics now. I'm just gonna move them to last 28 days. I'm gonna have to move them over a little bit more, but they'll still break it down by country, by location, through YouTube searches. But I've often found that just recently I started playing with the numbers. And like I said, if we go now to the last 365 days, the list is gonna, you see?
400,000.
That's minutes watched. You're still gonna find the thorium guy up there. Cold case files up there, but something interesting happens. The best thing I've ever done was one, it was in a Toastmasters group, and it was just how to answer and win one of our contests called Table Topics. And you know, the thing is, it's I'm in probably the top maybe 2% of YouTubers, because there's over 400 subscribers to my channel. This is just a little part of the hobby that I do, but you know, you do get a little bit of exposure, and you can do all kinds of stuff with this thing.
Hey, Tim, does the word subscribe mean payers? Or
no, it means people who have actively subscribed to my channel get notifications when it gets up there.
All notifications.
Anytime it goes out to Google Plus or Facebook, you'll be notified when I post.
Gotcha.
See, and then what this is there's enough people. And then some of them are from, like, India, Pakistan, because it'll break everything down. So we are starting to see quite a bit of watching here. We are starting to see startup. Now, if we go to demographics, for example, what? This is over the whole thing.
How's it going to know demographics?
By the click, by the IP address of people who sign into their account. our largest is male is between the ages of 25 and 34 years. And as you can see, you know, a lot of watch time on them, to break down by device, by things like this. It can also break it down geographically. I have a friend of mine who loves numbers. And she says, just take a quick look at everything. You would be absolutely amazed about what you'll find when you do things. I still think it's a hot, you know, it's something, but it's a little bit of success that I'm seeing with this stuff. And I mean, you know, you guys help make it happen, but you know, everybody craves a little bit of recognition for a job well done. Everybody craves a little bit of something else. And you know, like I said, our Donald Trump, I was completely expecting to go viral within hours, but it hasn't yet. Maybe about 10, 12 people have watched it so far, but you know, there have been some people who posted something up and it's gone viral. I'll tell you that one of the things that really shocked me was when we had a seventh grader post a little video for her class project on how does a thorium molten salt reactor work. Her name, she was a seventh grader. The next thing you know, she's got over 1 million hits on her classroom project.
How does that happen?
Just by sharing. They do a good video and people share it, or they look at it, or it comes up at the top, or it's just any number of ways. If you make something good and people like it, they're going to see it and they're going to multiply it.
Friends of friends,
Facebook, you know, anything else, you know. Some of the most stupidest things, you know, get up to the top of the list. The
kitty cat thing.
Well, not the kitty cat thing. Beavis and Butthead recently has been real popular.
All right.
And somebody made a video of Donald Trump and Pence would be like Beavis and Butthead. And that got well over 1 million hits. Sometimes, for me, like with him puzzling, I'll do what I call surfing the web, because most people only go to about 8 to 10 different websites, their Facebook account or this, but they don't do what I call doing freebasing the web.
Uh-oh.
Meaning that you go in and you just, okay, put up a Tor browser, move through it, a great amount of things, and just go somewhere that you've never went before, you know. I found, for example, Press TV out of Iran. It's their government news station. I one night I was just curious about how to get in all the foreign news feeds. I've also found the nightly news from Israel is pretty good. But I'll be talking about that at some other time. Bottom line, you have a passion, pursue it. You never know who you're going to meet or what you're going to do. Any other rebuttals? Steve, why don't we get closed out tonight then?
All right.
Can you take the last
one? How are you guys?
All right, I want to thank everybody for coming on out. It was a good, fun presentation. Thanks for sharing everything. And you got to take some puzzles home for gifts, for entrance fees, whatever you want to do. You got to take at least 3 puzzles home per person. We ain't taking any of these home ourselves, okay? Music, puzzles back here, puzzles over here, music, let's go. Come get them. Thanks a lot, and meeting adjourned. All right.
Attaboy, Steve.
Hey, it's good house. Come on, get some more puzzles, man. 2, 3 more. Get them.